Sri Lanka's embattled president submits his resignation. The parliamentary speaker's office says Gotabaya Rajapaksa emailed his resignation. The office, however, says the authenticity and legality of the email will have to be verified before being formally accepted. Rajapaksa would be the first president to resign since Sri Lanka adopted a presidential system of government in 1978. A formal announcement is expected Friday. Rajapaksa fled Sri Lanka after protesters overran his palace over the weekend. He landed in the Maldives on Wednesday and left for Singapore a day later. Singapore's foreign ministry confirms Rajapaksa has been allowed to enter the city-state for a private visit, adding he has not sought nor been granted asylum.
Former UK Finance Minister Rishi Sunak comes out on top in the latest round of voting to decide Britain's next prime minister. Sunak finished with 101 votes, while committed ex-Brexiteer Penny Mordaunt was a strong second with 83 votes. Six other Conservative MPs are vying for the position. Sunak and Health Minister Sajid Javid quit last week in protest of Boris Johnson's scandal-hit administration, setting off a wave of government resignations that forced Johnson to step down as Conservative leader. He is the early favorite among bookmakers, but Sunak has refused to distance himself from Johnson's administration, saying he will take no part in rewriting history that seeks to demonize the former premier or deny his efforts.
Increased production costs pushing up the price of rice in Metro Manila. The U.S. Department of Agriculture meanwhile projects the Philippines will need to import up to 3.1 million metric tons of rice in 2022 and 2023 to meet the demand. Lady Vicencio tells us more.
Rice suppliers from Nueva Ecija are now charging an additional 10 to 30 pesos for every caban of rice. This has prompted retailers to jack up prices of up to 3 pesos per kilogram of rice. Traders say the hike comes after the series of oil price hikes and farmers increasing farm gate prices. For many consumers, this price adjustment will make it harder for them to manage their budget.
Yung 35 at saka 48, pinapaghalo ko, isang kilo. Eh, para humaba yung ano, yung buying power, eh, magpapasokan na, mag-iipon na ako para meron ako mabigay na pamasahe.
A report by the United States Department of Agriculture shows the country's rice importation for 2022 and 2023 is projected to reach 3.1 million metric tons, or 100,000 metric tons higher than previous estimates. The report states that the bigger rice production does not offset the expected rise of global consumption, including in the Philippines. This means there will be a higher demand for imported rice from Vietnam, which in turn makes importing this staple more expensive for the government. The Philippine Statistics Authority recorded a decline in rice production by 20,000 metric tons last January to March as compared to the same period last year, but production increased by 60,000 metric tons throughout April to June. For agriculture group Samahang Industriya ng Agrikultura, the country only needs to import 2.7 million metric tons of rice based on the current production and demand. The group says this should be enough to fill the 4 to 15% of the demand.
Yung increase ng ahin, wala pa kami makitang significant up to this year. Almost the same with last year pa rin ang anihin natin. So, kaya may pagkakulang pa rin ang ating production dito sa ating bansa. Kita natin lumaki yung import. So ang administration kasi is towards importation. So ngayon pa lang ang ating presidente, nag-iinganyo na mag-local produce. Pero hindi natin makita up to end of the year ma-achieve kagad.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who is the concurrent Agriculture Secretary, is reassessing the rice tariffication law, which lifted rice import limits to the country, if it's still beneficial to farmers and consumers. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.
And look now at the financial markets. Wall Street tumbled on Thursday after investors digested disappointingly quarterly results from two large U.S. banks and hotter-than-expected inflation data. Both JPMorgan Chase and Morgan Stanley reported slumping profits and warned of an impending economic slowdown. Advancing microchip stocks, meanwhile, helped nudge the Nasdaq composite to a nominal gain. European stocks also closed lower, still on the back of America's four-decade high inflation print for June. And here in Asia, markets mostly fell after the central banks of Singapore and the Philippines both whipped out off-cycle interest rate increases. The PSEI dropped 0.1% to finish at 62.48.